Hello everyone. Today we'll learn how to set up kubectl autocomplete that will help you to work on Kubernetes cluster faster. It will effort your time. So let's start the topic now. So before that, what I'll do is I'll do a kubectl get nodes. Yeah, all my worker nodes are ready, and as well the kube master is ready as well. So let me see if I have any parts. Kubectl get parts. Nothing is there in the default namespace. Yes, I have a couple of webnet pods that is crash loop backup. Okay, I'll check into that. And you can see all these pods that it is running on the kube system namespace. Let's before delving into all these Kubernetes commands or kubectl commands, we will see how to make these things easier. So we'll set up the kubectl autocomplete stuff. So I'll do the kubectl autocomplete for bash. So that will do the kubectl autocomplete. So if you give anything, let's say if I give okay, get comp words by reference. Okay. So we hit by error kubectl. Okay. So bash get comp words by reference command not found. Okay. So let's install. Bash completion. Yeah, now we have done the source bash kubectl completion bash. Now let's do the kubectl get. Still not fixed. Let me just fix it. So I've just logged out and login in again and did the source kube completion bash. And I can get the tab completion now. If you see it, kubectl g. You get all the commands that starts with G, or else if you do not give any thing and just double press your tab, you should get all the command reference here. And so get paths, nothing is there. So that will solve your purpose of getting the bash completion. But we need to do the source once we log out and log in again, we need to do the kube completion bash again. So to do that across your login and logouts, so what you can do is you can add that into a bash RC file so that it will be done automatically. It will be permanently added. So what I'll do is I'll add that to my bash RC, and that should be it. I should be able to do it once I log out and log in. Okay. Further, if you want to set alias, like you every time you want to put kubectl and then go for it, right? Get all your commands to it. So it might be annoying to some of you. So what you can do is we can do a alias setting for this. I'll do a alias and then do complete hyphen f start kubectl k. So k get auth. Yeah, that's it. That's it for today's video. Thanks for watching this video. I'll come up with new videos every now and then on Kubernetes. Please do subscribe to my channel. See you next time. Bye-bye.